Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Viewers and listeners, you're watching us live on YouTube. My name is Suleiman Isyaku Muhammad, a behavioral analyst in the discipline of sociology, particularly criminologist by profession. Today, our topic of discussion is going to relate in the field of sociology, that is the wider horizon of sociology. It's not only a discipline that people have to study for career purposes, it has gone beyond that. Sociology today has encompassed all human endeavor, what you do at family level, at individual level, at thinking level, an aspect of interpersonal relationships. We need some elements of sociology to monitor our responses, our actions and reactions to phenomena around us. Globally, behaviorism, or issues that has to do with the dynamism and changing patterns of security matters, criminological challenges, all put together require expertise, require knowledge. So sociology, since its inception, is in line with adjusting changes, phenomena that generate these changes, so as to find a lasting solution to issues related directly to our society. The discipline itself, what does it mean? A lot of people define sociology before they get to the field. When you say sociology, people think about behavior alone. Some people think about gestures. Some think about smiles, and some think about love. Some think about crime. Some think about juvenile delinquency. But it goes beyond that. Sociology is the only discipline that engineers human behavior, just like the way we have the electrical engineers who are professionals when it comes to electricity and electric plants. So we have the civil engineers who are directly related to aspect of civil, aspect of building, architecture, etc. We also have the mechanical engineers who are professionals in aspect of rebuilding, remaking. So we have sociology. Sociology is a discipline that engineers the society. What does it mean? First, if you're a student of sociology or you intend to know sociology, the first thing you should know is, what does it mean? You don't know the meaning of sociology until you know what society means, what is encompassed. When you say society, what do we mean? Does it? The virtue of defining society differs from how it is being viewed in other disciplines. Society at sociology level, a society is a network of social interaction between individual groups and institutions. This network of interaction that allows for connectivity, that allow for interpersonal relationships, that allow for communication possibilities is what we call society. In other words, when we say society, we mean a network of social interaction between individual, group, and institution. What do we mean when we say between individual? When two or more persons meet in a market square and decide to communicate or transact either in horizon of business or in activity, those individuals are interacting. It may be of a group, one particular social group and another, depending on the group, whether a small group or larger group. As much as this individual there are interconnecting, it may be within institutions, for example, where particular institutions intercommunicating with another. Let's say the political institution in Nigeria, for example, having a relationship with the university, which is also another institution in itself, which is part of the educational institution. So you might find a correlation between, a relationship between the political institution and the economic institution in a particular networking. So that's what we mean by a society. Cut it short, is a network of human interaction, which happen within the individual, group, and institution. Then, if we look, always when we interact with people, there are outcomes, or we call them consequences of social interaction. When people interact in a society, either at a market square or at a family level or at a friendship, you find some creativity out of it. This creativity may be positive and it may be negative. If they are positive, we see them as the engine of development. If they are negative, we see them as the minions that can curtail development, or minerals that can discourage development. All these issues put together necessitate the study, individual professionalism in understanding this society. What is it? Why do people behave the way they do while they're interacting? Why do they act? Why are some people getting angry easily? Why are some people trying to involve in community development activity? Why is it that some people don't care whether they hurt others or not? And why are there differences in behavior? All this put together is called societal dynamism. It's why sociology is there. Then what is sociology? That's the question. The first question people ask themselves when they join the discipline is, what does it mean? Because by virtue of simple mental thinking, you think a lot. That it means me, it means people, it means all around me, it means everything. No, but it has a very, very comprehensive definition. Sociology is a scientific study of human society. It studies individual interaction, group interaction, and institutional association. What do we mean? When we say sociology, we mean the scientific study of human society. What do we mean? Why sociology is science? We're talking about behavior and now we're talking about science. Yes, because the word science connotes knowledge, a body of knowledge. I know when we're in secondary schools, when you talk about science, we mean physics, chemistry. No, when you say science, it means the method and techniques of acquiring information systematically. Any method that creates logic and rationalization is called science. So science is a systematic body of knowledge. Then since sociology deals with knowledge acquisition pertaining patterns of behavior, reactions, crime, delinquency, and development, then sociology is a science. So when you say sociology, what should come to your mind first is two words. One, science. Two, society. Sociology is a scientific study of human society. It studies individual interaction, group, and institutions. Then the next question we should ask ourselves after knowing that sociology is the scientific study of human society is the question, how? How sociology study individuals scientifically? Sociology starts by studying the individual themselves, their behaviors. How do they behave? What makes them to behave in a particular manner? Why is their individual who grew up in the same family, the same roof, under the same parental care, but having a variety in behavior? Why? Sociology need to answer that question. That's why sociology study behaviors. Then how those behaviors emanate, how they generate, how they affect, and how they generate more reaction. What do you mean how they generate more reaction? If I am a person, I behave to you with a lot of anxiety, it may generate you to react. Maybe I was very angry at you, and that anger causes you to react in a particular way. Then what do I do? Then I have my behavior have provoked your action. Then your action is a question here. Is it a positive one or a negative one? That's why sociology needs to study it. If it's a positive one, sociology will say its advantages. If it's a negative one, sociology will try to prescribe and warn the society against that particular reaction to that behavior. The next lecture is, you cannot further elaborate and know sociology much until you know how it relates with other disciplines. We call it the relationship between sociology and other social sciences. But is that the first thing we should do? Yes, that's the first thing we should do. We should know whether it is connected with other disciplines or not. And that will be our next lectures. Stay with us for the next episode.